Hello and welcome to the Vaults of Terra. My name is Ed and today we're going to be continuing with our overview series with a quick look at the Adepta Sororitas, also known by some as the Sisters of Battle. Now the Adepta Sororitas, also known as the Sisterhood or the Daughters of the Emperor, are a religious order linked to the Ecclesiarchy whose membership is entirely made up of women. Primarily a religious order, they are also renowned fighters and are known for hunting down corruption and heresy from within and without the Imperium with great zeal. It should be noted that the terms Adepta Sororitas and Sisters of Battle are commonly used to mean the same thing. However, the Sisters of Battle refers only to the Order's militant, the military arm of the Sororitas, and the largest part of the organization, but does not refer to the entirety of the Sisterhood. Now, the overview for the Sororitas is that they have many roles within the Imperium, but the main one is as the Ecclesiarchy's military arm. The reason this order specifically takes up arms on behalf of the Ecclesiarchy is due to the Decree Passive, the rule that the Ecclesiarchy cannot maintain any men under arms. The aim of the decree was to limit the Ministerium's influence in military matters, but they used the wording to allow for female soldiers to be armed and trained through the Sororitas, utterly devoted to the Emperor, the Imperial Creed, and the Ministerium, supposedly in that order. Their primary duties are usually focused around hunting for heretics, although they will take up arms against any who threaten the sanctity of an Imperial world. Their passion and devotion also means that members of the Ordo Hereticus will usually use the Sisters when facing large numbers of heretics to support Inquisitorial Stormtroopers, whose numbers are usually far lower than that of the Sisterhood. Now, a little bit of background history, which was actually covered in one of my early History of the Imperium videos, specifically relating to the Age of Apostasy. Now, the Adeptus Sororitas date their founding to the 36th millennium, at the end of the Age of Apostasy. They originate from another order which was originally known as the Daughters of the Emperor, an all-female cult dedicated to worshipping the Emperor on the world of San Lior. Now, the Mad Gorge Vandyr, the High Lord of the Administratum and the Ecclesiarchy of the Adeptus Ministerium at the time, heard of the Daughters and sought them out, convincing them that he was a saint of the Emperor, or the Emperor Incarnate, sources vary. They began serving Vandyr directly on Terra, becoming known as the Brides of the Emperor. Now, they continued to serve him until the siege of the Emperor's palace, when many forces of the Adeptus Terra came to remove Gorge Vandyr from his position of power. Now, the Sisterhood defended Vandyr, still believing him to be the religious icon that he wasn't. This lasted until a member of the Adeptus Custodis convinced the leader of the Sisterhood, through some means, possibly by taking the Sister before the Emperor himself, that Vandyr was evil and manipulating them for his own sake. Outraged, the head of the order returned to Vandyr's throne room. Here, the only words she said were to condemn him before cutting off his head. Now, after the battle, the newly appointed Ecclesiarch, Sebastian Thor, proclaimed the Decree Passive, which forbade the Ecclesiarchy from having any men under arms, as mentioned previously. However, he allowed the newly formed Sororitas to remain, recognizing the need for the Ecclesiarchy to have some kind of internal fighting force. Unfortunately, this completely disregarded the spirit of the decree, but did allow for the Sisters of Battle to remain as part of the Adeptus Sororitas. This has now led to the order we see before us today. Now, the organization of the Sisters of Battle is a little bit different to that of usual Imperial structures, so we'll just quickly go over the structure and hierarchy of both the orders and the ranks within the order as well. As I mentioned, the Sororitas is officially part of the Ecclesiarchy, but it is also divided between two covens, the Covent Prioris located on Terra and the Covent Sanctorum based on Filia 7. However, there are also outposts for the Sisters right across the galaxy. Now, the Sisterhood is commanded by the Abbess of the Sororitas, elected either internally or by the High Lords of Terra. Currently, however, the position is vacant due to the previous Abbess's disappearance. Below the Abbess, the prioresses of the two covens are in charge of their covent and the orders within each covent. Now, the covents are organized into several orders with different roles and responsibilities. There are four distinct classes of major order, plus an unknown number of minor orders. The major orders are the Ordo's Militant, aka the Sisters of Battle, the Ordo's Hospitaller, the Surgeons, Physicians and Nurses of the Sororitas, the Ordo's Dialogus, Sisters dealing with languages and translation, and the Ordo's Famulus, Diplomats, Chamberlains and Advisors for the Imperial Noble Families. Now, it is not uncommon for a sister to transfer from one order to another, usually sisters of battle leaving the orders militant due to their age or due to injury. Now, overall, an order is led by a head canoness called the Canoness Superior. The order is then divided into preceptories, subsidiaries, or larger tactical detachments of up to 1,000 sisters led by a canoness preceptor. They are then divided into a commandery, smaller covenants or detachments with up to 200 sisters, led by a canoness commander. They are then broken into missions. These are the smallest organizations of sisters, consisting of a few sisters of up to 100, and are usually led by a simple canoness or lesser palatine. It should be noted that non-military orders operate mainly at mission and commandery levels. Preceptory is largely an organizational tier. Now, to go over the orders in a little more detail, the Orders Militant is commonly known as the Sisters of Battle, as mentioned, and they are the most numerous and well-known of the sisters, renowned for their power armor and bolters, making them a step below the Adeptus Astartes in raw power per soldier. They are known as the only official fighting force of the Ecclesiarchy, and often prosecute the wars of faith against any who are considered heretics. They also, as I mentioned, assist the Inquisition when required, as their faith is judged to be strong enough to deal with some of the minor or even major heresies that they have to fight. Now, there are also the Lesser Orders Militant. Now, these are smaller garrisons which have separated from the main order due to a lengthy detachment, and they also form their own identities. These smaller orders are referred to as the Lesser Orders Militant. In theory, the leaders of the lesser orders are answerable to the leaders of the major order that they spawn from. However, usually that these orders will lead themselves unless they are leaderless. The Orders Hospitaller, as I mentioned, are surgeons, physicians, and nurses. Now, their primary duties are to help the poor, and are present as healers in every organization within the Imperium, such as the Imperial Guard or the Adeptus Terra. The only organization they do not serve is the Astartes, who have their own apothecaries who can deal with their unique physiology. Now, the Order's dialogers help translate the innumerable dialects and slang used throughout the Imperium into workable Low Gothic. They also help the Inquisition by translating Xenos languages, and allow the Inquisition the use of their prestigious skills in order to discover what the Xenos are talking about. Finally, the Order Famulus are sisters organized to maintain households of certain Imperial governors and Imperial nobles, serving as advisors, and also serving as a reminder of who the nobility truly serve. Now, as I mentioned, there are also an unclear number of minor orders, and I can go through two of them now. The Order Sabine accompany the Missionarius Galaxia to rediscover new or formerly Imperial worlds that have gone out of contact, or never been in contact with the Imperium. There, they will help settle new worlds, or help convert an existing world to that of the Imperial faith. Of course, they also assist when the world resists the Imperial faith, usually being used to batter down any resistance. There's also the Orders Pronatus, specializing in retrieving, guarding, studying, and repairing artifacts of value to the Ecclesiarchy across the Imperium. Now, the ranks and positions of the Adepta Sororitas are one of the final things I want to go through with you today in this video. Now, as I mentioned, the Abbess of the Adepta Sororitas is the commander overall of the Adepta Sororitas, and is also the direct commander of the Covenant Sanctorum on Terra. Now, under that are the prioresses, the overall commanders of a single covenant. Under that is the canoness, which is a command rank divided into the canoness superior, which is a commander of the entire order, a canoness preceptor in command of a preceptory, a canoness commander in command of a commandery, that's lots of commands, and a palatine, a command rank below canoness. And finally, there is a sister superior, then a sister. Now, the ranks in the Ordos Militant are slightly broken up into several different layers, allowing for a more military command structure. Now, underneath the canoness would be a Celestine, an elite sister of battle, bodyguards for canonesses and palatines. Then there are the Seraphim, the elite jump assault sisters. There are the Dominions, standard battle sisters with special weapons, a Retributor, which is a standard battle sister with heavy weapons, and a Battle Sister, which is the basic rank within the Adeptus Sororitas. Virtually every battle sister will be wearing a specialized power armor, which allows them to fight with great strength, although not the strength of an Astartes, and they also wield bolters as their basic weapons. Again, these are not the same size or power of a standard bolter, but are of course still fearsome weapons in the hands of these sisters. It's also noted that they rarely wear helmets. A lot of the Sisters of Battle go into combat unhelmeted, although, of course, the armor does come with a helmet and will primarily be used when fighting in conditions which would not be convenient for those who are unhelmeted. So, that's everything I wanted to mention today. If you've got anything to say, you can leave it in the comments section below, or you can message me directly. If you'd like to discuss the Vaults of Terra more, or a general interest in discussing the lore, you can go to the Vox Relay, which is the Vaults of Terra forums, and is linked in the description below. Next time, we will be dealing with a few more Imperial Guard regiments, rounding off the major ones, and we will also be finishing up our overview videos by having a look at the Adeptus Mechanicus and the Inquisition itself. Once we've done that, we'll be moving on to our Horus Heresy videos, and then of course we'll be start moving on to things like Chaos, Xenos, and all the other aspects of the Imperium that we have yet to cover. So that's everything I wanted to mention today. See you next time on the Vaults of Terra.